In this short video, we're going to revisit the idea of eigenvalues, eigenvectors, and eigenspaces from a geometric point of view. So, quick review, if we have a linear transformation with its standard matrix A, if we have a non-zero vector, and of course that's essential, all eigenvectors have to be non-zero vectors. So if we have a non-zero vector, V, and its image is parallel to V under T, so T of V equals lambda V, or AV equals lambda times V, then that's an eigenvector. V is an eigenvector, and the lambda is that scale factor, is the eigenvalue. Now, remember that the zero vector is parallel to any vector. So if the image of a non-zero vector V is the zero vector, then that non-zero vector V is an eigenvector, and it corresponds to the eigenvalue zero. So let's revisit some simple linear operators on R2, which have very simple geometric interpretations. So let's look at the scaling operator. The only thing that the scaling operator does is it multiplies the vector times a scale factor k. Now this scale factor can be negative, positive, or it could even be zero. We're going to think of it as being a positive number, but there's no reason why it can't be negative. And so its standard matrix is just that number k times the identity matrix. And since this is a diagonal matrix, we don't have to do any work to find the eigenvalues. The eigenvalues are lambda equals k with multiplicity 2, because there's 2 k's on the diagonal. So let's look at some vectors here. So here's the vectors that I have here, and I'm sorry if it's a little hard to read the names of the vectors, but it's vector W, U is the green vector, V is orange, and Z is yellow. And when you apply the scaling operator, the scale factor 2, you're just going to multiply the length by 2. The direction doesn't change at all. So we just double the length, keep the same direction, which means that every vector is parallel to its image. And so any vector in R2 would be in the eigenspace corresponding to the scale factor lambda equals 2. So any vector in R2 is an eigenvector of S2. So this one is a little bit more complicated. This is our shear operator. Let me go ahead and move this out of the way a little bit. So remember what happens with a shear is that vector is sheared, but let me go ahead and explain what I'm saying here. That what happens is that the x component, in this case, is a vertical shear. So the x component doesn't change, and the y component gets shifted by k times x. K is the shear factor. So in other words, if I multiply this out, the x component does not change, but the y component is k times x plus y. So you take the original y component and then you add kx, you shift it. Now k could be a negative number here, but again, we'll look at it being positive. If we look at the standard matrix, it is a lower triangular matrix, so it's easy to find the eigenvalues. There's only one eigenvalue, lambda equals 1, but it has multiplicity 2, because there are 2 of those 1s on the diagonal. So let's look at some vectors under a vertical shear with shear factor positive 2. So what does that mean? That means that, so let's take the orange vector, which is V. Its x component, or the x coordinate of the head, is not going to change. But what's going to happen to the y coordinate is we're going to add 2 times its x-coordinates. X-coordinate is 1, so we're going to add 2 to it. So now it's going to lie up here, the head. The green vector, vector u, is 2 units away. Its x-coordinate, or the x-coordinate of the head, the x-component is 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. I have to shift that up 4 units. And then the magenta vector here, which is w, its x component is 2.5. So if I multiply 2.5 times 2, I'm going to have to shift its y component from 0 up to 5. And that's what we see here. But the z vector on the y-axis has an x component of 0, so 0 times 2 is 0. It doesn't get shifted at all. So that one is invariant. Vectors on the y-axis are parallel to the image, which would tell me that the eigenspace of this shear operator matrix, corresponding to the only eigenvalue, which is 1, is the y-axis. And so that's kind of interesting, right? Even though it's a 2x2 matrix, there's only one, or the eigenspace has only one dimension. There's only one linearly independent eigenvector. All right, a projection operator. So the projection operator should be pretty simple, but let me just do a quick reminder here. If I have, so that's my x-axis, my y and x-axis, I have a vector then here, which we will call v. Then to find its image on the projection onto the x-axis, well, we just go from the head of V straight down. Straight down means forming a right angle with the x-axis. And so then this vector down here on the x-axis, that is projection onto the x-axis of V. All right, so really all that's happening here is that you're setting the y component to 0. So that's what this matrix does. And again, we have a diagonal matrix, so it's easy to see that the eigenvalues are lambda 1 equals 1 and lambda 2 equals 0. And then it's also easy to see that projection operators are not one-to-one. And I'm going to see that in the next image. So for example, here I have two vectors, the orange vector and the green vector. And if I project those onto the x-axis, their projections are identical. And so that tells me right away that this is not a one-to-one operator. Moreover, anything that's on the y-axis, when it gets projected down to the x-axis, it gets projected onto the zero vector. However, if you have something that's already on the x-axis, then when you project it onto the x-axis, it doesn't change. And so what that tells me is that vectors on the x-axis do not change. So that means that they are eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. So that's anything that's on the x-axis. However, anything that's on the y-axis gets mapped to the 0 vector. So that would be any non-zero vector on the y-axis would be an eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda equals 0. What about a reflection? So if we reflect in the y-axis, we're looking at its mirror image, and that just means that what happens is the x component flips its sign, the y component does not change. And again, we get a diagonal matrix, so we can easily see that there are two eigenvalues, lambda 1 equals negative 1 and lambda 2 equals 1. So again, if I look at this orange vector, its mirror image is the reflection of mirror image in the y-axis is its reflection. And same thing with the green vector. The magenta vector is on the x-axis. Its image is still on the x-axis. It just points in the opposite direction. Whereas anything that's already on the y-axis, like the yellow vector, it does not change at all. So what does that tell me? That tells me that if you're on the x-axis, you are an eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue negative 1. Remember, so that's just going to say that A times W is negative W. So the reflection of W is negative W. On the other hand, if you're on the y-axis, you're not going to change. And so the reflection of z, this z vector, is just z itself. So it is an eigenvector corresponding to an eigenvalue 1. What about rotation? So we're rotating through an angle of theta. We take theta to be positive when we make a counterclockwise rotation. It has this standard matrix with cosines and sines. And we're not going to go through the algebra, but with just a little bit of work and remembering that cosine of theta goes between negative 1 and positive 1, you can show that all the eigenvalues, if you choose almost any value of theta except for theta being an integer multiple of pi, the eigenvalues are going to have a non-zero imaginary part. So they'll be complex numbers. And here I chose 3 pi over 2 as the rotation. That's 3 pi over 2 in a counterclockwise direction. Of course, that would be the same as going pi over 2 in a clockwise direction. So rotating the orange through 90 degrees clockwise and every other vector through 90 degrees, it's pretty clear that none of the vectors are parallel to their images. They've all been rotated by 90 degrees clockwise. And what does that tell me about the eigenvectors? Well, there's no real eigenvectors for a rotation, and except in that special case where theta is an integer multiple of pi. So let's look at just two projection operators in R3 to emphasize a couple of points. So I'm going to take an line L, which passes through the origins in R3. And what would be a projection onto L, a projection operator onto L? It maps a vector V onto a vector, proj sub L of V, which lies on the line. All right, so that's the idea, just like the projection onto the x-axis lies on the x-axis, projection onto an arbitrary line L will line on the L, and it's an orthogonal projection. That all that means is that the length ensures that V minus the projection is orthogonal to L. And we'll get a clearer idea in just a few seconds when we look at the diagram. We're not going to derive the standard matrix. It's not hard, but at this point in our discussion about eigenvalues and eigenvectors, it's not important. If you have a direction vector, though, with components A, B, C, it's fairly easy to write down the projection matrix. You have this 1 over the dot product of A, B, C with itself times you have a column matrix times a row matrix. Yeah, with the same components, A, B, C. And for all projections, the eigenvalues are always going to be either 1 or 0, and that should make sense. If the vector is orthogonal to whatever you're projecting on, in this case it's a line, then it's going to get mapped onto 0, which means 0 has to be an eigenvalue. And then if it is parallel to the line L, then it's already on the line L, and the projection operator does nothing to it. It remains unchanged, and so you'll have an eigenvalue of lambda equals 1. All right, so let's take a look at the picture here. What do I mean if I am projecting an eigenvalue? I mean a vector. So this vector, so let's understand this. I've got a line L. I'm going to make that into the normal line for this plane. The vectors W and V are in the plane. U is not in the plane. And the vector N is the normal vector to the plane, but it's also the direction vector for the line. So if I project U onto N, then I just come in here and draw a right angle from the head. So I drop a line from the head of the vector U down onto the line L, and it's got to form a right angle with the line L down here. And so in that case, let's see, what color can I use? So I end up using white. Then this vector right here would be the projection onto L of the vector U. So that's what I meant by saying that if I take the vector U and I subtract the its projection onto L, the difference there is going to be orthogonal to the line. So let's think about this then. Any vector that's parallel to L does not change, and so it is an eigenvector if it's non-zero, right? Any non-zero vector parallel to L, that means lying on top of L, does not change, so it's an eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. So that would be any vector parallel to the direction vector. Remember, this is passing through the origin, right? And then vectors orthogonal to L, so any vector in the plane, because the way I drew this, the direction vector for the line, so this is the normal line for the plane, the direction vector for the line is the normal vector for the plane. So all of the vectors in the plane are orthogonal, and they get mapped onto 0 when they get projected onto the line. And so the eigenspace corresponding to the eigenvalue 0 is every vector in that plane. Now, that was projecting a vector onto the line. Let's project a vector onto an arbitrary plane. So it's a plane, uppercase pi, it passes through the origin, it has to be a subspace. And so a projection onto pi takes a vector v, and it maps it onto a vector which is in the plane, and again, we want to have it an orthogonal projection, so v minus its projection has to be orthogonal to pi. And we'll draw that picture again in a minute. We're not going to derive the standard matrix. It's much more complicated than even the one for projecting onto a line. But again, because this is a projection, the eigenvalues are 1 and 0. The difference is now the eigenvalue lambda 1 equals 1 has multiplicity 2, but the eigenvalue lambda 2 equals 0 has multiplicity 1. So again, let's think about this. We are going to have a vector u, which is outside the plane, n is the normal vector. Vectors w and v are in the plane, so their projections don't change. All right, they're already in the plane. But for u here, what I'm going to do is I start from the head and then I draw a line straight down, meaning a line that will make a 90 degree angle with the plane, and then this vector out to that point, that will be the projection onto pi of the vector u. So if we think about this, any vector which is parallel to the normal vector is going to get mapped to zero. So that would, if it's a non-zero vector, it will be an eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue zero. Anything that's in the plane is already in the plane. It's not going to change. Those would be eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue one. So a vector is orthogonal to the plane, meaning parallel to the normal vector, are going to be mapped to zero, and they'll correspond to the eigenvalue zero. So in summary, what have we seen here? We've seen that if you have an m by n matrix, it could have n linearly independent eigenvectors. And we saw that with our scaling operator, right? Its standard matrix is just k times the identity matrix, and you can just choose the eigenvectors to be the unit or the standard basis vectors. Or you may have only one linearly independent eigenvector, like a shear matrix. So the vertical shear matrix, the only eigenvector was the E2, or the vectors parallel to the y-axis. You could have no real eigenvectors. That doesn't mean there's no eigenvectors. It just means they are complex valued, or they have values which have non-zero imaginary parts. Eigenvalues can be positive, negative, zero. They can be rational numbers or irrational numbers. All of our examples are going to have rational numbers for the eigenvalues. And your eigenvalue multiplicity could be between 1 and n. So the kernel of a transformation, which is the null space of the corresponding matrix, is an eigenspace, right? If A has a non-trivial null space, so there are non-zero vectors in its null space, then any of those non-zero vectors is an eigenvector of A corresponding to lambda equals zero. We've talked about that and seen many examples, particularly with projection matrices. So for any square matrix, whether it has a trivial null space or not, the eigenspace of A corresponding to the number zero is the null space of A. So if the null space of A consists of only the zero vector, that would also be the eigenspace corresponding to the number lambda equals zero. In that case, lambda equals zero is not an eigenvalue. And this gives us yet another way to determine if a matrix is invertible. You can say that a square matrix is invertible if and only if lambda equals zero is not an eigenvalue of A. So if none of the eigenvalues of A are zero, they could be negative numbers or positive numbers, but if none of them are zero, then you can say that it is an invertible matrix. Now, when we start talking about invertibility, we also may talk about rank and nullity. And so it is true, it's always true, that the nullity of a matrix A is the dimension of the eigenspace corresponding to the number zero. So again, if there's only the zero vector in there, the dimension is zero and the nullity is zero. However, we can't just quite yet determine the rank of A by counting the non-zero eigenvalues of A. We actually need more information. Here's a real simple example which tells us that counting the non-zero eigenvalues is not going to give us the value for the rank. Look at this matrix here. Its eigenvalues are all zero. It's an upper triangular matrix. The diagonal entries are 0 and 0. So it has lambda equals 0 with multiplicity 2. But it's clearly not rank 0. It is going to be a rank 1 matrix. It has one linearly independent row or one linearly independent column. So even though there are no non-zero eigenvalues, its rank is 1. So we just have to be a little bit careful about that. And we'll see how this is connected in our next video.